Well, he telepathically communicates to the mayor when he makes his prognostication, so I don't know, unless I'm the mayor of Sun Prairie, what he actually sounds like. I was going to say, if you want to make a bulldog noise, I think you could pull that one off.
Sounds like Bill Murray.
Well,
Murray is a ground dog. How about
fair
that?
Enough. For nearly 50 years, Zimbrick Honda has provided the Madison area with quality Honda vehicles, and the trusted staff of Zimbrick Honda's used car dealership will save you time and reduce your car buying stress by finding the vehicle that matches your style. If you're in the market for a new Honda or a used Honda, visit Zimbrick Honda in Madison or online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Dennis, tonight we look forward to this battle in the North Shore Conference. The Nicolet Knights, 13-3 overall record on the year. Last year they fell in the Division II state semifinals to Pewaukee. They went on to win the championship, and they only lost to the Pirates by 2 points. This is a team that has its eyes set on another chance to get back to the Kohl Center in March and compete for a gold ball.
Yeah, the Knights, they've been a power here. They won the Division II title in 2019. They've made four appearances, like you said, last year. They lost to Pewaukee, kind of a disputed call at the end, a couple of free throws. So maybe left a little bitter taste in their mouth. They'd love to come back, and wouldn't mind seeing them at the Kohl Center here in a couple of weeks.
And meanwhile, the Cedarburg Bulldogs, record of 10-6 on the season. They are 7-6 in North Shore Conference play. That's tied for third in the conference. But when we look at this conference, it's a loaded one. And Dennis, the Bulldogs, upset-minded here on the home floor tonight to take down Nicolet in a revenge game after they met earlier in the season.
Yeah, you got Homestead and you got Nicolet kind of a little bit above everybody else. But any given night, you better bring your A game. And the first time these two teams met, Nicolet cruised to an 88-65 victory. But there'll be a big piece missing tonight. All I need to know about the Bulldogs is they're feisty. That's the kind of team I like. We're going to see guys dive for loose balls. We see guys taking charges. Guys just good team basketball. A few football players on this team. Both teams actually have a little bit of a physical presence from their football teams in the fall. And looks like we got some kind of a pink out night, I think, for the Bulldog students. A lot of people were in pink over there, but growing up in Fredonia, Cedarburg, Mequon, Belgium, that area, you know, North Shore, I grew up with that kind of basketball. Grafton, I mean, following those teams over the years. So it's cool to be in this gym, an old style. It's like a new gym, but it's still with the bleachers. It's got that old style feel.
Zimbrick Honda's presentation of PrepMania brought to you by the GRB Academy, baseball for the serious player. The GRB Academy wants to be part of your plan to reach your potential. Utilize GRB Academy's 52,000 square foot facility, 14 batting cages, and 6,000 square foot weight room. Personal lessons available year round, and with over 300 college players and over 150 Division I players, the GRB Academy leads the way in the Midwest for college recruitment and player development. Visit grbacademy.com. for more information. Coming up next, we'll hear from Kira Jones, this week's UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week, as we count down to tip-off of Nicolet and Cedarburg on Zimbrick Honda's presentation of PrepMania on 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand.
Since 1962, Stoughton Trailers has been a family-owned and operated business. With competitive wages and excellent benefits, plus growth and advancement opportunities, Stoughton Trailers is an exciting place to grow your career. Join the collaboration, innovation, and dynamic team atmosphere at Stoughton Trailers. With positions now open in production, operations, finance, sales, engineering, supply chain, and more. Go to stojobs.com to apply today. Stoughton Trailers, big opportunity.
Hi, it's Eric from Canopy Wealth Management. We're an independent, fee-based firm specializing in customized investment management, tax-aware wealth planning, and personalized client service. We're a steward along your financial journey because you deserve more than a run-of-the-mill experience. Canopy Wealth Management. Care, competence, clarity. It's not just a tagline. It's a promise. Go to canopy-wealth.com to get started today. That's canopy-wealth.com.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
Your nationally ranked Wisconsin men's basketball team is gearing up to face Big Ten opponents in Madison, and we need you to help bring the energy to the Kohl Center. Secure your tickets now, as inventory is limited. For more information and to purchase single game tickets, visit uwbadgers.com or call 1-800-GO-BADGERS. That's uwbadgers.com or call 1-800-GO-BADGERS.
Mark Tauscher here to tell you a little bit more about Everlight Solar. We all know that electricity costs are on the rise. That's why you need to talk to my friends over at Everlight Solar. Their local team here in Madison is here to keep it simple. From your no-cost consultation to solar panel installation, the team at Everlight Solar will be with you every step of the way. Not only will they help you save money, but by switching to solar, you're also helping save the planet. Everlight Solar, a proud partner of Wisconsin Athletics. Check them out at everlightsolar.com.
Listen to Wilde and Tausch, presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin on 100.5 ESPN.
So a lot of times you'll be like at a pool and you'll see these little cute little kimono dragons.
Komodo. Kimono is like an outfit, gown.
Yeah.
It's like a okay. Robe.
Wilde and Tausch, weekdays 9 to noon on 100.5 ESPN. Also brought to you by Grassland Dairy, Holman Lindsay Paints, Coors Light, Made to Chill, and American Family Insurance. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Zimbrick Honda's presentation of PrepMania, 100.5 ESPN and Wisconsin On Demand. And we welcome all of you watching on the ESPN Madison YouTube channel for the Nicolet Knights and the Cedarburg Bulldogs tonight on PrepMania. Jesse Nelson with the Dean Dennis Semrau. PrepMania brought to you by Pasquale's Cantina. Before or after the game, Pasquale's Cantina is the perfect spot for authentic Southwest flavors right here in the Midwest in the Madison area. Whether it's to fulfill your craving for red chili, their famous chips and fresh guacamole, or those blue corn tortilla tacos, Pasquale's is the place to enjoy time with friends and family. Visit one of their locations in Middleton or Verona today, or check out the menu and their food online at pasquallescantina.com. Bringing the flavors of the Southwest to the Midwest, Pasquale's Cantina. It is time now as we count down to tip time for Cedarburg and Nicolet to bring you this week's UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week. For over 90 years, UW Credit Union has helped Wisconsinites achieve their financial goals at every stage of life, offering great rates for greater possibilities. Join today at uwcu.org. UW Credit Union, proud to support all the area's student athletes. Make sure to listen every week to hear the UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week. This week, it's Madison East's Kira Jones.
Our ESPN Madison UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week, Kira Jones. Welcome.
Hey.
You're the baby of the family, right? I think I've covered your older siblings playing sports.
Keontae Jones, he played basketball and football here. Kenny Jones, he played football and basketball here as well.
And sister?
My sister didn't play any sports here.
As the baby, some benefits, but I'm sure they beat up on you a little bit growing up.
Definitely. Always, actually.
What did you learn? What did they teach you about sports?
You got to have a lot of confidence with sports, like, and to be tough, because I was always pretty soft until this year, I feel like.
When was the first time you picked up a basketball?
I think I was like 6, and then about 8th grade, I started taking it serious. I just was getting super tall, I felt like, and I was like, I could be really good at this sport. And then I started like falling in love with it for real and being really competitive with it, going to the gym with my brothers.
You were in the old East gym, which you never got to play in.
No,
but you saw some legends.
Who
were the ones growing up that you followed that kind of inspired you as a player, guys and girls?
Aaron Howard, and then Anthony Washington, Keyshawn Justice, Keontae, my brother, and Kenny. I look up to them the most. It's a lot more, but off the top of my head, that's who I think of the most.
Well, it's your third year of varsity.
Mm-hmm.
And then last year went off a track, and I'm sure that helps conditioning for basketball
season.
Definitely. Now you played some AAU basketball.
Yes, I played with Premier and Illinois Legends.
And that had some East End LaFollette
guys. Yeah, we had, so like the starting five on LaFollette, they were all my teammates. And then like Valerie, who's on my team right now, she was on Premier as well, mixed with like East End LaFollette players.
Well, East Side Pride, that's a big thing.
Mm-hmm.
And who's got bragging rights right now?
Me.
You do?
Our team, my team. Like, we got the bragging rights.
Okay. Now you want to go on and play in college recruiting? You need some interest?
Yeah, I'm getting recruited. A lot of JUCOs. I got my first D2 offer like a couple of days ago. I'm happy about that. I'm still just waiting. I'm in the moment right now, so I don't want to commit right now.
Oh, you're having fun playing with your team, right?
Yeah, I'm enjoying like my last few moments of high school, really just embracing everything right now.
And what do you want to study in college?
Kinesiology, yeah. I want to be a physical trainer or like a coach, but kinesiology is what I'm looking into for sure.
Coach, now you do some work, I understand, MSCR.
Yeah.
What's that about, working
yes.
with kids?
I like working with MSCR because the kids, like, they're just funny. I love working with kids. I think it's because I only have one nephew, so I was rarely around kids, and I'm the baby, so like he was the only little kid I'm around. So I've always wanted to like be around more kids.
Do you work at a particular school? Or?
Yeah, I've worked at Gompers Elementary, and I've also did Camp Compass at Warner Park.
When you look at being a part of the school, what does being a Purgolder to represent East, what does that mean to you?
Being a leader, yeah, just being a leader. I feel like East presents that a lot, like wanting more leaders coming out of the school.
Awesome. We're our ESPN Madison UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week, Kira Jones. I hope you have a great rest of your senior year.
Thank you.
Hey everyone, Molly Brown from ESPN Madison here for the best Southwestern food in the Madison area. It's always Pascual's Cantina for me and my family. Whether I'm enjoying my favorite taco salad, their awesome chips and guac, or one of their famous burritos, Pascual's is the best for authentic Southwestern fare. Visit one of their locations in Verona or Middleton today, or check out their menu and order online at pasquallscantina.com.
Bringing the flavors of the Southwest to the Midwest. Pascual's Cantina.
The GRB Rays have established themselves as one of the top baseball programs in the Midwest and the country. GRB Academy offers training programs for players of all ages and skill levels. Learn from some of the best baseball coaches in the area and find the program that fits your training goals and your schedule. Spots are filling up fast, so visit grbacademy.com to sign up now. That's grbacademy.com. GRB Academy, baseball for the serious player.
Whether you're an artist playing accountant, a barista trying to be a bean counter, or a student just looking to get started, the UW Credit Union.
Blood drive for the community to the community. Friday, February 16th from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. at our Community Health and Wellness Center, 3162 County Road B. Mask optional, appointments encouraged. Sign up online at bloodcenter.org or call 800-747-5401, group code 3643. That's Friday, February 16th. Learn more at stoughtonhealth.com. Creating excellence together.
Since J&K Security Solutions opened in 1987, our attention to detail and customer service have been our strongest assets. I'm President Jeffrey Beckman. We'll always do our best to find the most efficient and cost-effective solution to every job we tackle. Whether it's security for your home or business, installing video surveillance, or being able to control your garage doors from your phone, we can help you feel empowered with simple and user-friendly technology. Let's work together to secure your home or business. JKSecurity.com.
For official rules and more information about every contest on 100.5 ESPN, visit ESPNWisconsinContest.com. That's ESPNWisconsinContest.com. You're listening to 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN app.
You're listening to 100.5 ESPN, the ESPN app, and Wisconsin On Demand.
Zimbrick Honda's presentation of PrepMania, 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN Madison YouTube channel. We greet you from Cedarburg High School as we get set for the fourth-ranked Nicolet Knights and the Cedarburg Bulldogs in the North Shore Conference. Jesse Nelson and the Dean, Dennis Semrau, as we get set for tonight's game. And yes, we are looking forward to what should be an exciting one. It is Nicolet and Cedarburg squaring off. Time now to get to our Canopy Wealth Management Keys to Victory.
Presented by Canopy Wealth Management. Plan for your future with Canopy Wealth Management. Visit canopy-wealth.com.
And Dennis, When we talk about those Canopy Wealth Management keys to victory, of course, we mean Canopy Wealth Management as a balanced approach to help guide you through a complex and ever-changing landscape. Throughout your family's financial planning journey, they'll serve as a partner, advocate, and steward to help achieve your goals with confidence. At Canopy Wealth Management, they believe values matter and strengthen the community. When you work with Canopy, care, competence, and clarity isn't a tagline, it's a promise. Go to canopy-wealth.com to get started today. Let's go ahead and start, Dennis, with the Nicolet Knights. What first, is the key all, to victory for that?
There's no second shots. Limit Cedarburg to 6 offensive rebounds. Very specific. Patient offense, take the best shots, and don't gamble on defense. They love to, their defense creates the offense. Don't take too many chances.
And how about the upset-minded Cedarburg Bulldogs at home?
At home, well, control the boards. Don't give up too many offensive boards. That's, again, that's where the Nicolet offense begins. Limit unforced turnovers. Look for great shots. They're gambling scrambles, so they're going to get a lot of good looks. But be patient. Don't throw up that first shot.
PrepMania brought to you by Stoughton Health, where they provide trusted care close to home. They're proud to support all the area's student-athletes and wish them all the best this season, from rehab to ortho care. Stoughton Health provides comfort and convenience locally. Visit stoughtonhealth.com to learn more. We'll be back for the opening tip in 2 minutes on Zimbrick Honda's presentation of PrepMania on ESPN Madison and the ESPN Madison YouTube channel.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at 2 convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
The GRB Rays have established themselves as one of the top baseball programs in the Midwest and the country. GRB Academy offers training programs for players of all ages and skill levels. Learn from some of the best baseball coaches in the area and find the program that fits your training goals and your schedule. Spots are filling up fast, so visit grbacademy.com to sign up now. That's grbacademy.com. GRB Academy, baseball for the serious player.
Zimbrick Honda's presentation of PrepMania on ESPN Madison and the ESPN Madison YouTube channel. Jesse Nelson and the Dean Dennis Semrau for a big game in the North Shore Conference. The Nicolet Knights, fourth ranked in the state, taking on the Cedarburg Bulldogs. Dennis, we were here in part to see Davion Hannah, the four-star recruit, a junior for Nicolet, 33rd ranked recruit in the country according to ESPN's recruiting rankings. He is out tonight with the flu. So he was not participating, which means Cedarburg sees an opportunity to win this game outright and still compete for a chance at a conference championship. The Bulldogs win the opening tip, working left to right as we see it and as you see it on the YouTube channel, and we are underway. Cedarburg wearing their home white uniforms, orange and black trim with orange and black letters and numbers, and they lose it on the opening trip down the floor. Nicolet will get possession after stepping out of bounds on the baseline 14 seconds in.
Yeah, went right away to Zaire, who's their leading scorer at 19.6 points a game, and he saw an open baseline, but foot a little too far outside.
Right side, Dave Bolden now pitch it out to the right-hand side. Bolden driving baseline, lost control.
Guess what?
And stepped out of bounds on the baseline. That possession took 13 seconds and results in a turnover. Similar starts for both teams up and down the floor to begin this game in the North Shore Conference. Nicolet in their road navy blue uniforms. Nicolet in cursive script across the front in baby blue letters and numbers with a baby blue trim. Spin move on the left block, and Griffin French, the junior, lays it up and good for the first points of the game. Cedarburg up 2-0. Fade it down low underneath, and a travel is called on Tyler Bender, the senior, getting the start in place of Davion Hannah, out with illness tonight. So Cedarburg gets it back with a 2-0 lead, 55 seconds into the contest.
Four possessions, three turnovers. We're off to a roaring start tonight.
Handoff near the midcourt line. Right side now, Logan Zaire pitches it back. Zach Brown for three, no good off the back of the rim. Rebound Nicolet. Nasir Beeman comes in front, and it's stolen away by Griffin French for Cedarburg. Picks up his dribble, needs some help. Bounce pass was dangerous, but it ends up in the hands of Zach Brown. Brown across the timeline, right side of the floor, one-on-one. Now passes left side into the hands of Zaire. Zaire into the paint. Euro step to the bucket, no good. Offensive board and a putback, yes. Mitchell Chakowski, the junior, 4-0 Cedarburg, minute and a half into the game. Great start for the Bulldogs, Dennis.
Yep. Two layups and versus three turnovers on the other end for Nicolet. Nicolet is going to be playing full court pressure, trying to create offense off their defense.
Beeman for three, no good. Batted around into the hands of French for Cedarburg. Nicolet with no points, nearly 2 minutes in. French up the floor, spin move in the paint, bounce pass, baseline, contact, foul, shot no good. Jack Dykstra will go to the line. Dykstra, the second leading scorer for the Cedarburg Bulldogs this season, averaging 15 points a game. He's a 68% free throw shooter.
And Bender picks up his first foul, as you said, in for Davion tonight.
So, Dennis, let's talk about it now. With Davion Hannah out tonight, the top recruit, one of the best recruits in the country, let alone the state of Wisconsin, how does Nicolet make an adjustment, and how much different is their game without their star?
They're still going to try to go full court pressure. They're still going to try to score off their defense. And all it means is that Nasir Beeman, who's averaging 16 points a game, and Dave Bolden, 11, they're going to have to pick up their games a little bit. Beeman, like Hannah, was on that Milwaukee Academy of Science team that was a Division IV state a couple of years ago. He is a top-notch player, so it's going to be his turn to shine tonight.
Both free throws good at the line for Dykstra. 6-0 Cedarburg, 2 minutes and change into this game. Nicolet up into the front court now, right side of the floor, dribble all the way to the top of the key, pass it right side, pump fake beyond the perimeter, and instead Damon Landrum decides to put it down. Bounce pass, tiptoeing the sideline. Bolden able to maintain possession. Free throw line extended left. Pull-up jumper no good. Long offensive rebound collected. Beeman to the bucket. Lays it up with the left hand. Good. Nasir Beeman, first points for the senior. And Nicolet's first points of the night with 15:23 to go in the game, or in the first half at 6-2.
So what Cedarburg wants, they want to be able to make Nicolet play in the half court, making it work for their shot, and they got an offensive rebound. That's one of the keys to the game, keeping them off the glass.
Beeman is called for a foul, trying to get a loose ball, so Cedarburg keeps possession with a 6-2 lead, 15-15 to go in the first half on Zimbrick Honda's Prep Mania. Cedarburg last season finished 14-12 with an 11-7 conference record in North Shore play. That was good for a fourth-place finish. They fell to conference rival Whitefish Bay in the Division II regional final. They have their eyes set on a longer postseason run this year. Pull up three, no good, but an offensive rebound for the Bulldogs, and it ends up back in the hands of Zach Brown near midcourt. Brown trying to pass left side, had it batted, loose, scramble for it on the floor, and a foul will go against Cedarburg, meaning Nicolet gets possession with 14:54 to go in the opening quarter. Cedarburg 6, Nicolet 2 on Zimbrick Honda's Prep Mania.
And Tchaikovsky, their 5'10 junior guard, picks up the first foul.
Now the inbound pass comes in all the way to the backcourt into the hands of Rashad Davis. Davis dribbles across midcourt, center of the floor, pass right side, trying to find somebody down in the post. That's Bender taking the place of Hannah. Hannah usually has a little more of a size advantage than Bender does. Driving right side with contact. Shot is good and a chance for a three-point play. Nasir Beeman goes to the line to try and cut the Cedarburg lead to one.
He is going to be a tough act to handle tonight.
And not only was that a great play sending Beeman to the line, but he drew the contact on Zaire. Logan Zaire, the leading scorer for Cedarburg. the 6'3 junior, averaging 20 points a game. With Hannah out, he is now the leading scorer among all players per average per game entering play tonight. Beeman's free throw no good. Cedarburg takes possession, up by two. 14-25 to go in the first half. Magic number tonight, Dennis, without taking into consideration, as the three is good for Zach Brown, left side. 9-4 Cedarburg with 14-10 to go. We'll get to that magic number at our next stoppage. Driving left side, contact shot no good. Bender to the free throw line, shooting two with 14:07 to go in the half. So for those unfamiliar, I understand Cedarburg and Nicolet, not our usual audience in the Madison area. The magic number, taught to me by Bradley Braves, play-by-play announcer Dave Snell. Nicolet fans should know about the Bradley Braves, with Darius Hannah, the older brother of Davion, playing there right now. 98% of the time, team that scores this number goes on to win the game. It has not missed on Prep Mania since the state tournament in 2017. Tonight's magic number, Dennis, 72. 72 is our magic number. 2-for-2, Tyler Bender at the free throw line. Of course, I didn't take into consideration an adjustment for the best player for one team being out. So we'll have to see what leads to.
Yeah.
At least 72 for now. If the magic number fails tonight, we have an asterisk on our hands. 13:50 to go in the first half. 9-6. Cedarburg leads Nicolet in the North Shore on Zimbrick Honda's Prep Mania. Spinning downhill in the left side of the paint. And a whistle as Logan Zaire, still looking for his first points of the night, is called for a travel. Couldn't keep the pivot foot down. It's turned over to Nicolet with 13:45 to go in the half. Here come the Knights, lost at the Kohl Center in the Division II state semifinal last year by 2 points to the Pewaukee Pirates, who went on to win the championship outright. Nice shot, left side, right side. He was able to get it to fall. Left side as I'm looking at it from the baseline here. 9-8, Cedarburg's lead down back to just one again. And the Knights apply some pressure. Cedarburg able to break it into the front court, but a travel is again called on Dykstra. The senior got a little happy with some room trying to get to the bucket. And Nicolet gets the ball back looking for the lead for the first time tonight.
Back-to-back traveling calls for Cedarburg. That's their fifth turnover. Nicolet had three on their first three possessions. They've been clean ever since. That's one thing that Cedarburg's going to have to limit, those wasted possessions.
Right side three off the side of the backboard. No good. And now it's loose. Nicolet maintains possession. An errant throw, preserving it on the sideline by Landrum, ends up in the hands of the Cedarburg Bulldogs. Driving downhill left to right into the paint. And look at that move by Zaire. He forced it up and it rolled in. 11-8. Cedarburg up by three. First points of the night for the leading scorer, Logan Zaire.
Second team all-conference. He's one of the top defenders in this conference as well.
Retaliation three, no good. Two chances at a putback. The second goes for Bender. First field goal of the night for Bender. He has 4 points. 1 point game, 12:25 to go first half. Cedarburg and Nicolet on Zimbrick Honda's Prep Mania. Jesse Nelson, Dennis Semrau, making the road trip from downtown Madison to beautiful Cedarburg for tonight's contest in the North Shore.
It's a great place to be before Christmas time. They decorate the town so well.
Steal, bounce pass ahead, and a layup is good for Bolden, and Nicolet has the lead. 12-11 with 12:05 to go, and a timeout is called by Cedarburg head coach Nick Miller to talk things over with the Bulldogs. 30-second timeout, we'll take it with them. 12-11, Nicolet leads Cedarburg on Zimbrick Honda's Prep Mania.
Hey everyone, Molly Brown from ESPN Madison here. For the best Southwestern food in the Madison area, it's always Pascual's Cantina for me and my family. Whether I'm enjoying my favorite taco salad, their awesome chips and guac, or one of their famous burritos, Pascual's is the best for authentic Southwestern fare. Visit one of their locations in Verona or Middleton today, or check out their menu and order online at pasquallscantina.com.
Bringing the flavors of the Southwest to the Midwest. Pascual's Cantina.
So what did the Bulldogs say about that?
Jesse Nelson, Dennis Semrau, Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania, ESPN Madison and the ESPN Madison YouTube channel. Cedarburg trailing by one, 12-11, as we now get under 12 minutes to go here in the opening half. Bulldogs at home trying to pull off the upset against fourth-ranked Nicolet. And out of the timeout, Logan Zaire down on the left side post goes up off the glass and gives the Bulldogs the lead by one. Dennis, that seems like a formula that could work for Cedarburg tonight as Nicolet travels.
Their fourth turnover now. What did the Bulldog coach say at the huddle after that last turnover? That was rough.
I thought you had some insight because we're so close to the bench. No, he goes with a dog joke on me.
Classic. Take care of the basketball right away. Take care of the basketball. Six turnovers for Cedarburg, four right now for Nicolet, but it was good pressure defense there on this end.
That's what I get, having not done a basketball game with you for more than a month. Stolen away by Nicolet on a turnover. Here come the Knights in the front court, trailing by one, 13-12. Cedarburg on top, 11:20 to go in the first half.
Make it turnover number seven now for Cedarburg.
Bolden directing traffic, goes right side for Rashad Davis. Davis trying to shake the defender, French. Instead goes back up top to the volleyball line, halfway between the three-point line and the midcourt circle. Now over on the left-hand side. Trying to use a screen. Bolden can't get away. Resets. Give it at the top of the key. Beeman drives all the way. Left hand off the glass. Too strong. No good. It sat there for a second, and Cedarburg takes it in the front court. Trying to push. Oh, extra pass. And yes, Joa Kaminsky lays it up. Good for two. Three-man weave, and the Bulldogs have a three-point lead.
Kaminsky off the bench. First reserve points of the night here. All five starters for Cedarburg, by the way, in the scorebook.
Top of the key, trying to use a screen. Now an extra pass. Davis drives right side. Mid-range jumper, no good. Put back, no for Beeman. But another offensive board for Nicolet. Beeman gets fouled, and he'll shoot two free throws at the line. Clock stops with 10:18 to go in the first half. 15-12, our score.
Nicolet is just relentless on the offensive boards. And that's exactly why that was the number one key. And that's where their offense begins. And you've seen Beeman there. It's his second trip to the line tonight.
First free throw is good for Beeman. He's a 64% free throw shooter. He is the second leading scorer on the team behind Davion Hannah, who again is not playing tonight due to illness. Beeman averaging 16 points a game to go with four rebounds, shoots 58% from the floor. Second free throw is good. He has six of the 15 for Nicolet as the Knights take a one-point lead.
I don't see how he's only averaging four rebounds. He's already got four in this game. He only played 8 minutes.
I think because usually Hannah's down there helping clean
it
up.
Probably.
Hannah averages a double-double per night. Driving all the way into the bucket, Ryan O'Neill, the junior for the Cedarburg Bulldogs, had a wide-open lane. Defensive breakdown for Nicolet, and Cedarburg extends the lead 17-14 with 9:50 to go in the first half.
I feel like you bring a couple of subs in off the bench. Kaminsky and O'Neill, they both score right away. That's what you want. No drop off here.
Right side. Now swing it left to the top of the key. Dave Bolden. Bolden left to right across the paint. Now goes off the glass with contact, and the shot is good. Bolden to the line with a chance to tie the game with 9:32 to go in the first half. A whole bunch of fouls on Cedarburg. They're up to six now. That's the second on Owen Hallbeck. And what a job by Nicolet drawing contact by the Bulldogs and getting to the line so far in this game. Bolden's free throw is good. He has 7 points to lead the way for the Knights. Tied at 17 with 9:32 to go in the first half. We've got a good one tonight here in the North Shore. Nicolet and Cedarburg. No Davion Hannah, no problem. Well, maybe a little bit because Joa Kaminsky just got wide open down on the left block to lay it up off the glass. Good for two again. Dennis, that's back-to-back shots for Kaminsky. Wide open. Yep. And now he's got a rebound to go with it. Nope, correction. It's Nicolet basketball still on a steal. Shot no good. And this time, it's collected and protected by Dykstra. He gets it to Griffin French across midcourt. Pass to nobody. Goes out of bounds off the tarp. Turned over to Nicolet. Halfway through the first period. 19-17. Cedarburg leads Nicolet. Dennis, when they tell us the North Shore Conference is one of the best in the state, I think you can tell the intensity, the speed, the pace of this game. It seems higher than some of the ones we're used to seeing.
Yes. Both teams love to get up and down the court. Cedarburg a little bit more patient there. they create their offense in the more in the half court.
A little fancy flick from Rashad Davis, the sophomore. Number 11 in the road blues for the Nicolet Knights. Picks up his first points of the night to tie the game at 19. 8:30 to go in the first half. Extra pass, and Dykstra is right there to put it in for his first field goal of the night. 4 points for Dykstra, averages 15 a game. Cedarburg up 21-19. 8:20 to go in the first half. Cross-court pass, open three. Nope, Davis pump fake. Extra pass to the left wing. Three, halfway down and out. No good. Cedarburg rebound. Left side, Dykstra. Into the front court, kicks it out left wing, now into the paint. Downhill, left side, no good. Kaminsky, rebound Nicolet, coming this way. Dish it, Davis, downhill, block, lays it up, good for two. 4 points for Rashad Davis, and we're tied at 21. 7:50 to go in the first half.
That was a fast break. It shouldn't have been, but he just beat him down the court.
Off the screen, the three is good for Ryan O'Neill. 5 points for the junior wearing number 12 in the home white uniforms of the Cedarburg Bulldogs. 24-21, Cedarburg leads Nicolet. 7:30 to go first half. Left side baseline, kick it out, swing it, open three. No good for Beeman. Loose ball collected by Cedarburg. It was saved nicely by Landrum on the baseline, but he couldn't keep it with Nicolet, and in transition, an easy layup for Kaminsky, who just like that off the bench has 6 points. Cedarburg up 26-21.
Cedarburg giving Nicolet a little bit of their own medicine here, creating some offense off the defensive end.
Right side now top of the key, number 4, Beeman. Picks up the dribble, looks for help, finds it right wing. Open three, halfway down and out, no good for Nicolet. Rebound Cedarburg coming left side of the floor. Griffin French down to Dykstra. Dykstra picks up the dribble on the baseline. Touch pass right side, now all the way back to the top of the key for Zaire. Zaire steps back near the midcourt Bulldog logo. Passes right side. And the Bulldogs slowing it down now. It was a frantic pace for about 3 or 4 minutes consecutively. Cedarburg has it. Right side, into the paint. Oh, look at the move by Dykstra. Dennis, you like to see that. A little shake and bake by Dykstra. Didn't have the size advantage, but he went into the trees, shook the leaves, and got 2 points.
7 point, largest margin of the game right now. And both teams really working on inside. You've seen a few outside shots here, but primarily get the ball into the post. Some of the Badgers didn't do enough last night, right? Touch the post, get it inside, see what you can create.
Bulldogs by a touchdown, and we're used to saying that. They played in the Division III state championship for football this season. Knocked out Stoughton in the semifinals. And now Nicolet misses, and a shot out of bounds goes off the Knights. Turned over to Cedarburg, 5:52 to go in the first half, and a timeout. We'll keep it right here with 5:52 to go in the half, 28-21. Cedarburg leads Nicolet on Zimbrick Honda's presentation of PrepMania. For nearly 50 years, Zimbrick Honda's provided the Madison area with quality Honda vehicles. And the trusted staff of Zimbrick Honda's used car dealership will save you time and reduce your car buying stress by finding the vehicle that matches your style. If you're in the market for a new Honda or used Honda, visit Zimbrick Honda in Madison today or online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Dennis, 28-21, Cedarburg leads Nicolet without Davion Hannah. Does it feel like the Knights are struggling to find themselves?
A little bit, but you got to give credit to Kaminsky and O'Neill off the bench. They've combined for 11 points, and they're attacking the rim. They're getting some open looks. But both teams are really doing a good job. Nicolet just is not getting some shots to fall. You know, Bender has been crashing the boards. Beeman had a couple offensive boards early. But some of those shots start to fall. But, again, Cedarburg wants Nicolet in that half-court offense. They want to make them work for everything and frustrate them a little bit. They loved the showtime. They haven't had a chance for an open dunk. They want to get the crowd into it with that. Cedarburg's doing their best to make sure they play their kind of basketball, which is patient, but hey, they can still go a little up-tempo too. But not flashy, feisty, that's theirs.
Nicolet has not lost a traditional regular season game yet this year with a 13-3 record, undefeated in conference play. All three losses have come in showcases, two at the National Hoops Fest in Maryland early in the year, and then one at the Rick Majerus Shootout at Concordia University near the lake. Here is we're in southeast Wisconsin near Lake Michigan. Out of the timeout, Cedarburg basketball, and a foul is drawn, called on Bolden, and it sends to the line number 11, Logan Zaire. Zaire's first free throw attempt is up and good. Mentioned that Zaire's the leading scorer for the Cedarburg Bulldogs, averaging 20 points a game to go with 6 rebounds. And he's a good free throw shooter, 73% at the line this season. 2-for-2 on this trip as the second rattles in. 9-point lead for the Bulldogs at home against the fourth-ranked team in the state. Cedarburg 30, Nicolet 21. 5:30 to go in the first half. Top of the key swing at left, Bolden. Bolden driving baseline, picks up the dribble beyond the block, needs help, goes down underneath, and a little fighting 30. For position, and yes, it does go for Shimon Davis. First points for the senior guard of the Nicolet Knights. Davis in off the bench, cuts the Cedarburg lead to 7. Quick 3, right side, off the rim, no good, and a rebound is collected by Nicolet. Soaring up to get it, Rashad Davis, left side of the floor, blows past one defender. Davis, oh, with a reverse layup. He went coast to coast. Davis, rebound, drive, finish. 30-25, Cedarburg up 5.
You could say he wanted that one a little bit.
Yeah, just a little.
There it is.
3-point shot, Logan Zaire, good from the left wing. 39% 3-point shooter. 8-point lead for the Bulldogs, 33-25, with 4:30 to go in the first half. Right side of the floor, now back up top of the key, driving downhill, swing it right out of bounds. Nicolet threw it away, trying to do a little too much in transition. 4 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the half, and a turnover back to Cedarburg.
Nicolet taking a lot better care of the ball than they were when he turned it over in their first 3 possessions here. A little uncharacteristic.
Griffin French picks up the dribble, bounce pass left side, Zach Brown. Looks for help, gets it from French. French off the screen, comes to the top of the key for Dykstra. Cedarburg slowing the pace down this trip to the other end of the floor with 4 minutes now and counting to go in the first half. Bulldogs playing with a lead, upset-minded as Nicolet plays without Davion Hannah tonight due to illness. Down to the right block, turnaround, up off the glass, Reed Montag. Yes, sir, 10-point lead for Cedarburg, the largest of the night. Didn't think we'd be saying Nicolet has to figure out how to keep this game from getting out of hand, Dennis, but here we are. And now this one way too strong, misses everything. Rebound Cedarburg. Griffin French weaves his way through defenders across midcourt, left side. Now off the screen, Dykstra looks for help with movement away from the ball. Ends up back with French near the midcourt circle.
Oh, constantly moving. That back door has been wide open all night for Cedarburg. Looking to get that pass inside. Nicolet's playing some good pressure defense there, but Cedarburg is making sure they're going to the basket. They're not just moving the ball on the perimeter. They're looking inside. There's 3 again now. Dykstra cutting inside.
Montag to French, back off the screen. Now, Dykstra for 3, good. Open look is good. Patience perseveres. 38-25, Cedarburg by 13 with 2:45 to go in the half. Bolden picks up the dribble. Left side, and now out of control, Ogiello. Noah Ogiello, the senior forward, lost control, and it's back to the Bulldogs.
Number 3 key was look for great shots for Cedarburg. They're going to gamble and scramble, which is exactly what Nicolet's doing, and they're going to get some good looks, but you saw how patient they'd be. Don't throw up that first 3-pointer. They rotated, then they finally got the 3 they liked. Nothing but net.
These teams met on December 14th of this season. Nicolet crushed Cedarburg. 88-65 was the final score as Cedarburg turns it over with contact away from the ball. 2:26 to go in the half.
Coach Mueller, so that was a good game there. Just two spurts, and now otherwise they played even with them. So the key is, can they keep Nicolet from going off with that run? You know, we saw last night the Badgers 20-3. Hey, anytime you can keep a run down to 5 or 6 points, you're doing all right.
Step back 3 is good for Bolden. Falling out of his shoes as he goes back past midcourt. That was a much-needed shot for the Nicolet Knights to cut the lead down to 10. 2 minutes to play in the first half, 38-28. Cedarburg up by 10.
Ended a 12-2 run there.
French cross-court pass to the left side. Zach Brown now drives inside to the paint. Off the glass, too strong, no good. Rebound Nicolet, right side of the floor. Bolden, pull up, 3. And it's good. back-to-back triples for Dave Bolden. 38-31, the Knights can score quickly. 90 seconds to go in the first half, and a whistle goes against Nicolet. That's just the fourth team foul on the Knights, so several to give here as we approach the end of the half. Cedarburg has one to give before Nicolet would shoot any free throws.
And Bolden's second foul, only person with two, is Hallback off the bench for Cedarburg.
Inbound pass comes into Griffin French. French averaging 8 points a game for this season. Uses the screen, picks up his dribble right side. Cross-court pass, quick three. Off the front of the rim, no good for Kaminsky. Rebound Nicolet. Here comes Bolden, who's got the hot hand. Bolden kicks it to the right corner. Back for Bolden off the screen. Bolden trying to get in past the defender. Now drives in. Uses contact. Yeah. What a move. What a finish. Oh, Bolden. He's going for nine straight at the free throw line as it falls in a chance for three. A one-man band. Dave Bolden bringing the Knights back into this game before halftime.
14 points here, and he's got his own personal right now. 8-0 run. Is it going to be a 9-0 run?
It's not just Davion Hannah on this Nicolet team. Don't kid yourselves. Beeman averages 16 a game. Davis, 13. Dave Bolden averages 11 a game. He misses the free throw. No good. So it stops at 8 straight, at least for now. And now a whistle on Bolden, who might have been feeling it a little too much. He says, yep, my bad. That was the last foul. Or correction, they still have. Oh, wait a minute. No, this is a foul on Cedarburg. I saw that incorrectly. My mistake. That's a foul on Cedarburg, pushing Bolden away. He drew the contact. That's a great defensive play by Bolden. Now pulls up at the free throw line, and it's good. He's got 10 straight points. It was 38-25 a minute ago. It's 38-35 now. Cedarburg loses it out of bounds, last touched by Nicolet, so the Bulldogs keep it on their end of the floor with 41.9 to go in the half.
Don't see too many 10-0 runs by one player when we're seeing it tonight.
Starting to feel like Max Klezmann a few weeks ago on a Friday night at the Kohl
Center.
Yeah,
I was thinking
of
that. Magic Max.
Left side French. Start Golden Bolden, maybe? Want to roll with that?
Golden Bolden.
French left side. Out of the screen. Open three. Quick release. And it's so smooth for Logan Zaire. Second three of the night. Bulldogs up by six. Bolden has it. 20 seconds to go until the half. Right side. Bolden again. 15 seconds. Long three. Oh,
he got baby.
It. Are you kidding? Bolden with 13 straight. 41-38. Cedarburg by three. 4 seconds. Into the front court. Right side. Pump fake three. Step back shot. No good. And it's halftime. Woo! 41-38, Cedarburg leads Nicolet at the break. Dave Bolden finishes with 13 straight points for the Nicolet Knights to bring them back from down 13 to just 3 at halftime. We got to catch our breath. So this is what the North Shore Conference is all about. Halftime on Zimbrick Honda's Prep Mania. Cedarburg 41, Nicolet 38. You're listening to Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania on 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN Madison YouTube channel.
Brian here from Canopy Wealth Management. At Canopy, we commit to full transparency in everything we do. Because we're a fiduciary, we strive for the highest industry standards and honor our ethical duty to put your best interests first. Our balanced approach helps guide you through a complex and ever-changing landscape, creating a personalized wealth management experience. Care, competence, and clarity isn't just a tagline, it's a promise. Go to canopy-wealth.com to get started today. That's canopy-wealth.com.
UW Credit Union presents the Prep Mania Student Athlete of the Week, supporting local student athletes as they grow on the field, in the classroom, and in the community. UW Credit Union is here for every you. Learn more at uwcu.org.
Hi, this is Dennis Semerow from Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania here on 100.5 ESPN. We're very excited to partner with UW Credit Union to help bring you even closer to the stories of great young student athletes. Each week, as part of this season of Prep Mania, PrepMania will feature the UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week. UW Credit Union is proud to support local student athletes as they grow on the field, in the classroom, and in the community. And just like the fantastic student athletes we'll be telling you about all season, UW Credit Union's online banking also goes above and beyond with top-rated service and security that exceeds industry standards. UW Credit Union is here for you, presenting the PrepMania Student Athlete of the Week. Learn more at uwcu.org.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
Big trailers and big opportunity. Since 1962, Stoughton Trailers has been a family-owned and operated business, providing a professional yet casual work environment in Stoughton, Evansville, and Broadhead. If you're looking for your hard work to be rewarded with competitive wages and excellent benefits, plus growth and advancement opportunities, Stoughton Trailers is the spot for you. Positions now open in production, operations, finance, sales, engineering, and more. Go to stojobs.com to apply today. Stoughton Trailers, big trailers, big opportunity.
Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania on 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN Madison YouTube channel. For nearly 50 years, Zimbrick Honda's provided the Madison area with quality Honda vehicles, and the trusted staff of Zimbrick Honda's used car dealership will save you time and reduce your car buying stress by finding the vehicle that matches your style. If you're in the market for a new Honda or a used Honda, visit Zimbrick Honda in Madison today or online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Jesse Nelson to the Dean, Dennis Semrau in the North Shore Conference, Cedarburg High School. Dennis, we branded this game coming into it as a recruiting showcase to see Davion Hannah, four-star recruit, recruiting by a bunch of different schools. He's the 33rd ranked prospect in the class of 2025 in the state of Wisconsin and in the country. He's ranked number 33. Offers from Arizona State, Iowa State, Bradley, Marquette, Michigan State, Ohio State, Oregon, USC, Wisconsin. He's amazing. Averages 20 points a game, 10 rebounds. That's a double-double. He's electric. Nicolet's got a lot of other great players, too. Cedarburg is upset-minded, wanting to beat this fourth-ranked team on their home floor. It has turned into one of our best games of the year so far, 41-38 at halftime.
Yeah, it's incredible. It's everything cracked up to be. Unfortunately, we don't get to see Davion Hannah, but if you don't win conference titles with one player. You got to have it, and your players are going to have an off night. You got four guys that average double figures normally for Glendale, Nicolet, and three of them are still out there. So, and then you got Bender off the bench who's done a good job. We haven't seen much out of McKay tonight, who'd been hurt, sick. He's one that had the flu. I hope he didn't give it to Davion. That would be bad. You look at Nicolet returned the top six players from that group last year. They'd won eight of the last 10, so we knew it was going to be a good team regardless of what happened. And, boy, they really crashed the boards. They're looking for that interior shot, but they're not afraid to put a few threes up there either. It's whatever the – Coach Terrence about Terrence Smith. So do you guys shoot a lot of threes? He goes, we shoot the open shot. So if it's there, we'll take it. Good. That's coach speak. Yeah, we shoot the open shot. I love it.
Dave Bolden with 20 points to lead all scorers in this game, including the last 13 for the Nicolet Knights to pull them back within three before halftime. 12 points for Logan Zare, leading the way for Cedarburg.
I said coming in without Davion Hannah, either Bolden or Beeman were going to have to pick it up. Bolden was averaging 11-4 and Beeman just over 16. So Bolden's got 20 and Beeman's got 6. So, okay, now we'll see if it's going to be the sheer Beeman show here in the second half.
PrepMania brought to you by Stoughton Trailers since 1962. Stoughton Trailers has been a family-owned and operated business with competitive wages and excellent benefits plus growth and advancement opportunities. Stoughton Trailers is an exciting place to grow your career. Join the collaboration, innovation, and dynamic team atmosphere at Stoughton Trailers with positions now open in production, operations, finance, sales, engineering, supply chain, and more. Go to stojobs.com to apply today. On behalf of Stoughton Trailers, best of luck to all the participants in tonight's game. Stoughton Trailers, big opportunity. The second half coming up after this, 41-38. Cedarburg leads fourth-ranked Nicolet on Zimbrick Honda's presentation of PrepMania.
The GRB Rays have established themselves as one of the top baseball programs in the Midwest and the country. GRB Academy offers training programs for players of all ages and skill levels. Learn from some of the best baseball coaches in the area and find the program that fits your training goals and your schedule. Spots are filling up fast, so visit grbacademy.com to sign up now. That's grbacademy.com. GRB Academy, baseball for the serious player.
Hi, it's Eric from Canopy Wealth Management. We're an independent, fee-based firm specializing in customized investment management, tax-aware wealth planning, and personalized client service. We're a steward along your financial journey because you deserve more than a run-of-the-mill experience. Canopy Wealth Management. Care, competence, clarity. It's not just a tagline, it's a promise. Go to canopy-wealth.com to get started today. That's canopy-wealth.com.
Hey everyone, Molly Brown from ESPN Madison here. For the best Southwestern food in the Madison area, it's always Pasquale's Cantina for me and my family. Whether I'm enjoying my favorite taco salad, their awesome chips and guac, or one of their famous burritos, Pasquale's is the best for authentic Southwestern fare. Visit one of their locations in Verona or Middleton today, or check out their menu and order online at pasquale'scantina.com.
Bringing the flavors of the Southwest to the Midwest. Pasquale's Cantina.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania on ESPN Madison and the ESPN Madison YouTube channel. Jesse Nelson and the Dean Dennis Semrau. For every stage of life, UW Credit Union is here for every you. Proudly serving Wisconsin for over 90 years. Pop in or hop online at uwcu.org to join UW Credit Union. Proud to support all the area's student athletes. Make sure to listen every week to hear the UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week. Kira Jones of Madison East, this week's UW Credit Union Student Athlete of the Week. Second half of action in the North Shore Conference on Zimbrick Honda's Prep Mania. The Nicolet Knights in their road navy blue uniforms, cursive baby blue letters and numbers with a blue trim. Cedarburg in the home white uniforms, orange and black letters and numbers with an alternating trim. The inbound pass comes in. Nicolet working left to right as you see it on the ESPN Madison YouTube channel. The Knights closing the gap after trailing 38-25. They close the half on a 13-3 run, but Cedarburg starts the half by forcing a turnover at midcourt, over and back, which means back to Cedarburg. Bulldogs get it 19 seconds in And Dennis, the second half starts the same way the game started, with a turnover by one of these two teams.
Yeah, Nicolet had three in their first three possessions, ended up with six in the first half, and 10 turnovers overall for Cedarburg in the first half.
Cross-court pass open, three is good for Dykstra. Now matches Zaire with 12 points in the game, 44-38, Cedarburg leads Nicolet. This would be a statement win for the Bulldogs on the home floor tonight against their conference rival Nicolet. Trying to retaliate and doing so successfully, Beeman drives in with the right hand, scoops it off the glass, good for two. 44 to 40, I should say, is our score. Cedarburg by four. Lob pass and a slam! Oh. How do you do, Logan Zaire? It brings everybody to their feet. Welcome to the North Shore, Prep Mania. 46-40, Cedarburg up by six.
We had to wait about 20 minutes for our first dunk, finally, and it's a good one.
Nicolet, retaliation, oh, wide open shot, Bender missed it, too strong. Here comes Cedarburg, right side of the floor, extra pass inside, kick it, corner three.
Yes.
Is good, Zach Brown. 49-40. Cedarburg by nine, 16-15 to go in the game. Left side, Davis, off balance, contact. He threw it up off the glass, shot no good, but Davis will shoot two free throws, taking a hard hit to the floor. Clock stops with 16-11 to go in the game.
Cedarburg opened the game with a 6-0 run, and now here they're on an 8-2 run to open it up here. Keep an eye on we Bolden with 20 in the first half. Zaire, the best defensive player, who Coach Mueller thinks not just on his team but in the conference, is now on Bolden. We'll see how many shots he gets off here.
Rashad Davis, the sophomore, is a 47% free throw shooter on the season. He connects on the first at the line. The foul is on Chakowski. That's his second for Cedarburg. Second free throw is missed. It's about on par with the 47% average on the season for Davis, but it's out of bounds off of Cedarburg. So Nicolet maintains possession. Bolden will inbound beneath his own basket, but first a timeout with 16-10 to go in the game. 49-41, Cedarburg leads Nicolet. We'll keep it right here on Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania, brought to you in part by Pasquale's Cantina. Before or after the game, Pasquale's Cantina is the perfect spot for authentic Southwest flavors right here in the Madison area. Whether it's to fulfill your craving for red chile, their famous chips and fresh guacamole, or those blue corn tortilla tacos, Pasquale's is the place to enjoy time with friends and family. Visit one of their locations in Middleton or Verona today, or check out the menu and their food online at pasquallescantina.com, bringing the flavors of the Southwest to the Midwest. Pasquale's Cantina. You go by, you might see ESPN Madison's Molly Brown hanging out at Pasquale's Cantina. She tells you all about how great everything is over at Pasquale's. Dennis knows all about it. We had our Prep Mania end of season champions show at Pasquale's just a few short months ago. Off the inbound pass. Oh, look at the spin. Beeman to the hoop. 49-43 as Beeman lays it up good. He's got 10 points on the night. Under 16 minutes to go in the game. A long way to the finish line here on Prep Mania. Off the screen. Left side Dykstra, and a foul goes on Nicolet. Nope. I didn't think it did.
Player control foul.
I thought I saw Nicolet kind of put their heads back like, oh, you're calling that on us. But I stand corrected. That was against Cedarburg, as I think was the correct call on Dykstra. That is his third personal. Something to keep in mind, the second leading scorer for the Bulldogs this season, Jack Dykstra, averaging 15 a game, now playing with three personal fouls. Nicolet basketball down six in the front court. Into the paint, off the back of the rim, no good, too strong for Davis. Rebound Bulldogs into the front court with the right hand, charging his way forward. Zaire draws contact. I don't know how much of a continuation Cedarburg wanted there, but they ended up continuing to play, and the three was good from the corner. The NBA wouldn't have even have considered that as a continuation, so I don't know what the Bulldogs were looking for, but the inbound pass does come in from underneath, and up off the glass, no good. Batted around, Bulldogs maintain it. Nope, it's batted loose again. Nicolet has it. Davis in front of the pack, right side, throws it back to the top of the key. McKay, bounce pass right all the way to the corner. Three, no good for Davis. Loose ball, rebound on the weak side is collected by McKay. And contact against Nicolet driving inside. One of the Bulldog defenders drew it. I think it was Zare who actually stepped in.
Back-to-back player control fouls. Both teams.
McKay picks up the foul. Two fouls on each team here with just under 3 minutes in to the second half of this game. 49-43. Cedarburg leads fourth-ranked Nicolet. Top of the key, now bounce pass, down low, off the block, no good, too strong for French, did everything but finish. Rebound Nicolet into the front court, Davis steps back, nope, in front of the three-point line, low percentage shot, no good. Offensive board, put back, yes. Beeman has 12. Matches his first half total with six here, 3 minutes and 15 seconds into the second half. 49-45, Cedarburg up by four. Right side, now kick it in. One-on-one, down in the paint. Turnaround, off the glass. French, no good. Rebound, Nicolet. Cedarburg's been getting cold inside. Now Davis, lob pass, down to the right block. McKay, spin around, in the paint, no good. Batted off the bottom of the rim. Loose ball, collected by the Bulldogs. They'll push it out front. Left side, Brown. Whoa. Oh, rejected, but a whistle. Bender. Going to be called for the foul, and it'll send Zach Brown to the free throw line with 14-12 to go in the game.
That's Bender's third foul now.
Bender getting the start tonight in place of Davion Hannah, the four-star recruit, 33rd-ranked prospect in the class of 2025 nationally by ESPN. He has the flu and is not playing in tonight's game. Zach Brown's first free throw is good, 50-45. ...14-12 to go here in the game. Magic number 72. Keep that in mind, Dennis Semrau. 98% of the time, team that scores 72 going to go on and win this game. Sets, fires, second free throw, good for Brown. Approaching 4 minutes into the second half. 6-point lead for the Cedarburg Bulldogs. 10-6 on the season. All of their losses coming in conference play. They have a 7-6 conference record. Nicolet is undefeated in conference play, 13-3 on the season. Shot no good. Cedarburg gets it into the front court. A tall pass, and if it wasn't collected by Owen Hallbeck, it would have gone to Dennis Semrau. Hallbeck
maybe
gets it back, left side. You were ready. Off the screen, Zare. Left wing, dishes, Hallbeck. Feeds down to the left post. French had it stripped away. Taken away by Dave Bolden. Bolden between the legs. Pass and contact off the glass. Beeman gets the shot and a foul. Chance for three at the line. Nasir Beeman.
Good assist.
...13-24 to go in the game.
Now that's Tchaikovsky's third foul.
And now foul trouble starting to add up for some Cedarburg Bulldogs. North Shore Conference not disappointing us here on our first game. Making a road trip on Zimbrick Honda's PrepMania. Nicolet and Cedarburg.
Yeah, weather was good. It's a good night for a little road trip.
Three-point attempt at the free throw line is no good, but an offensive rebound by Nicolet, and a shot goes for McKay, and he's fouled. Just a couple of seconds tick off the clock, and now McKay goes to the line to cut it to one if he can make the free throw. 4 points and counting on this trip down the floor for the Nicolet Knights.
And Hallbeck picks up his third foul. That's three players now. Cedarburg.
The free throw is no good for McKay, and now a whistle on Nicolet as the rebound soared into the air. They're going to get Shimon Davis for that foul. Four team fouls apiece. 13-15 to go in the game. Cedarburg by two, 51-49. Pass down low. Oh, an extra pump fake by Zare, who got it back, drew contact, and got the shot to fall. Chance for a three-point play of his own on this end. Logan Zare. And the Cedarburg Bulldogs extend their lead.
piling up the fouls here all of a sudden both ways. McKay with his second.
53-49, and the free throw is good. Zaire converts the three-point attempt.
The old-fashioned three-point play.
Five-point lead for Cedarburg, 5 minutes in to the second half.
And once again, Zaire taking Bolden one-on-one.
Beeman, spin move. Oh, bad shot, double-teamed, and it's no good. Rebound by the Bulldogs. Fourth-ranked team in the state on the ropes, on the road tonight. Undefeated in conference play, Nicolet. Trying to avoid its first traditional loss of the year. All three of their losses have come in tournament showcases so far this season. A whistle away from the ball goes against Cedarburg. Nope, correction. They're going to get Damon Landrum of Nicolet on the foul there. That's his first of the night. But that is the sixth foul on Nicolet. They have no more to give.
Bonus, baby, coming up. Here we go.
With 12:37 to go in the game, Cedarburg in the bonus.
Get ready for a long one. We're going to be here for a while.
Pass down low, shot no good for Hallbeck. Yeah. Got his own rebound, draws contact. The shot no good on the second attempt. Hallbeck will shoot two free throws at the line. Clock stops with 12:27 to go in the game. Prep Mania brought to you in part by Stoughton Health. They provide trusted care close to home, and they're proud to support all of the area's student-athletes and wish them all the best this season. From rehab to ortho care, Stoughton Health provides comfort and convenience locally. Visit stoughtonhealth.com to learn more. First free throw is good for Owen Hallbeck, 6'3 junior, averaging 7 points a game on the season, just a 44% free throw shooter. That was his first point of the evening.
I'll take it. Back up to six.
Hallbeck's second free throw, high off the back of the glass, no good. And now a whistle. Nicolet's furious with it. And what are they going to say? Is this Cedarburg basketball? Are they giving him another free throw? Well, I suppose
it looked like a clean rebound coming off. Somebody must have got some contact pushing before the ball in the air.
The officials converse, and they're going to overturn it.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know what the official near midcourt saw.
Looked like a good rebound there from McKay. Strong board. All is 6'7". See why they were happy to give him back tonight without Hannah.
12:15 to go. 55-49, Cedarburg by six. Driving left side, downhill, no good. Too strong, rebound Cedarburg. Here it comes the other way. Scoop it up and good. Ryan O'Neill out in front. 57-49, Bulldogs by eight. Right side, Bolden had the hot streak right at the end of the first half to bring Nicolet back from down 13 to just three when the teams retreated into the locker room. And now a loose ball underneath, and a foul is called on Cedarburg.
Alternate possession.
That's what they're going to say.
Call a tie-up, yeah. 20. Credit Hallbeck, 22, with getting a hand in there on the rebound.
Saw head coach Nick Miller right in front of us here on the baseline, a little upset with whatever was being called on that end. I think he thought that his team had been called for a foul just like I did. Instead, it is Bulldog basketball. Cedarburg up eight, under 12 minutes to go in the game against fourth-ranked Nicolet. Bounce pass to the top of the key, Zaire. Kicks it right side, O'Neill. Intercepted as he tried to go to the corner for Bolden. It's the other direction. Nicolet, right corner. Now Davis. Back to Bolden. Bolden, pump fake three, now takes it. Off the front of the rim, no good. On a bounce, collected by O'Neill. O'Neill out in front is grabbed.
Intentional. Nope. Coach wants an intentional.
I didn't think it was intentional, but it does lead to a one and one for the Cedarburg Bulldogs and Ryan O'Neill. And that's the trouble of being in the bonus already. If you're on the defensive side for Nicolet, Cedarburg, with any contact, and this game is so physical in this conference, they're going to be shooting free throws all night long. Sets, fires, O'Neill missed it, and a rebound, Nicolet, and a push on Bolden. And you can just sense the frustration now from the Nicolet Knights. They finally get something to go their way with the whistle here in the second half with a missed free throw on the one and one, and then they get called for a foul collecting the rebound.
And that's Bolden second and the team ninth.
Now Zaire to the free throw line, who's a better free throw shooter, and Zaire hits the first. 58-49. Cedarburg looking for a double-digit lead with 11:23 to go in the game. And they have it. Logan Zaire, unofficially 19 points.
Yep, that's what I got.
11:15 to go. 10-point advantage.
Yep.
Down left side, Beeman lays it up and good. Beeman's got 10 points this half. 16, trailing only Bolden for Nicolet. And a timeout called with 11:10 to go. 59-51, Cedarburg leads fourth-ranked Nicolet. We'll take a 30-second timeout with them. You're listening to Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania on ESPN Madison and the ESPN Madison YouTube channel.
Hey everyone, Molly Brown from ESPN Madison here. For the best Southwestern food in the Madison area, it's always Pasquale's Cantina for me and my family. Whether I'm enjoying my favorite taco salad, their awesome chips and guac, or one of their famous burritos, Pasquale's is the best for authentic Southwestern fare. Visit one of their locations in Verona or Middleton today, or check out their menu and order online at pasquale'scantina.com.
Bringing the flavors of the Southwest to the Midwest. Pasquale's Cantina.
Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania on ESPN Madison and the ESPN Madison YouTube channel. For nearly 50 years, Zimbrick Honda's provided the Madison area with quality Honda vehicles, and the trusted staff of Zimbrick Honda's used car dealership will save you time and reduce your car buying stress by finding the vehicle that matches your style. If you're in the market for a new or used Honda, visit Zimbrick Honda in Madison today or online at ZimbrickHonda.com. And I even recommend, if you live down here in Cedarburg, you got any friends and family that attend Nicolet High School, make the drive up. It's worth your time to go to Zimbrick Honda on the west side of Madison. Jesse Nelson, Dennis Semrau out of the timeout. Bulldog basketball, the Cedarburg Bulldogs. 10-6 on the year, 7-6 in North Shore Conference play, looking to hand the Nicolet Knights, fourth ranked in the state, their first loss in conference play this year. A steal and an easy score on the other end for the Nicolet Knights and Shimon Davis. Out of the timeout, Cedarburg did not handle the pressure well. It's a 6-point lead for the Bulldogs at home. 10:30 to go in the game. Right side, Dykstra.
Once again.
And it's stolen. Bolden out front. Bolden lays it up and good. That was not easy. He was contested from behind. And now Cedarburg needs a timeout with 10:21 to go in the game. We'll keep it right here. 59-55 is our score. Cedarburg's lead back down to just 4 points. Prep Mania brought to you by Canopy Wealth Management, where they have a balanced approach to help guide you through a complex and ever-changing landscape. Throughout your family's financial planning journey, they'll serve as a partner, advocate, and steward to help achieve your goals with confidence. At Canopy Wealth Management, they believe that values matter and strengthen the community. When you work with Canopy, care, competence, and clarity isn't a tagline, it's a promise. Go to canopy-wealth.com to get started today. And Dennis Semrau, if we look back at those Canopy Wealth Management game plan keys to victory, Cedarburg's doing something right, but Nicolet is storming back.
Yep. The big one is the turnovers right now here. Limit unforced turnovers. It's back-to-back turnovers for Cedarburg, and they were able to capitalize Nicolet on a couple of fast break layups. Again, Nicolet creates so much of its offense off its defense. When you give them a couple of airs right there, give them 3 points, and all of a sudden now we're back into single digits. It was an 8-0 run, and now it was answered quickly by a 4-0 run. Yep, a 6-0 run.
6-0 run. It was a 10-point lead for Cedarburg. It's down to four. Now the Bulldogs break through the pressure out of the timeout, and a foul is called at the top of the key. Double bonus the rest of the way for the Cedarburg Bulldogs. And to the line goes one of their best free throw shooters, Logan Zaire. 73% on the season. Clock stops with 10:13 to play. 59-55, Cedarburg leads Nicolet. The Knights without four-star recruit Davion Hannah for tonight's game. They still have three other players that average double digits nightly, including Beeman, Davis, and Bolden, as Zaire misses the first free throw. Cedarburg is no slouch, though. You got Zaire averaging 20, Dykstra 15, French and Hallbeck with 8 and 7. And a couple other players that are in that mix, too.
They can put up points. They put up 94 in a win over Racine Park at the Holman Showcase at Brookfield Central. So they can score with the best of them.
60-55 after the second free throw is good for Zaire. Left side, open three. Front of the rim, no good. Nicolet, offensive board, yes. And a putback is good for Rashad Davis. First field goal of the second half. He has 9 points in the game. 9:50 to go, 60-57, Cedarburg by three. Bulldogs across midcourt, right side of the floor. Bounce pass, dangerous. It's collected, but lost out of bounds by Dykstra. Inside too many defenders there. Lost control of it, a little out of control and out of sorts that entire trip down the floor for the Bulldogs. Between the legs, dribble, Bolden goes left side. They're a three-point shot away from tying the game. Nicolet, 13-3 on the season. Here's the three, right side, no good for Davis. Bounces out into the hands of Cedarburg. Long pass, extra pass, quick down the floor. Off the glass, spinning out of control, no good. Bulldogs still have it, and a layup is good for Logan Zaire. They're flying around at Cedarburg High School. 62-57 approaching the midway point of the second half. Three-point shot left wing, no good. Soaring into the sky, Dykstra collects it. Cross-court pass immediately. French had it deflected by Bolden. Nicolet's got it. And a foul. No, a double dribble is going to be called on Nicolet. So the Bulldogs get it back. One thing after another in this game. Bolden almost made his way into the broadcast booth with us here, Dennis.
Well,
that was out of control
right.
for both teams.
Yeah, Nick, 15 turnovers now on Cedarburg, but then Nicolet gives them the ball right back.
8:50 to go, 62-57. We've got a great game in the North Shore Conference tonight on Zimbrick Honda's Prep Mania. Down to the right block, and a whistle goes against Nicolet, Shimon Davis.
Be his third.
8:40 to go, and two free throws upcoming for the Bulldogs. Dykstra to the line, a 68% free throw shooter. Dennis, I understand Davion Hannah's not playing tonight, but if I didn't know any better, I would say the Cedarburg Bulldogs are a team that with the right seating and the right matchups have a chance to contend in the postseason a long way this year.
Yes, they do.
We'll see how they close out this game here in the second portion of this half.
That last basket they had, missed shot, 22, Halbeck crashed the boards. And where was Zaire? Crashing right behind him. Nice assist, easy layup. Both teams really hit the offensive glass great. You talk about following your shot, they follow everything.
Dykstra 1 of 2 at the line, 63-57. Cedarburg by 6, 8:40 to go in the game. Driving right side, Bolden off the glass, no good. Second chance, no, but a foul on a shot attempt for Beeman. He'll go to the free throw line, and he's slow to get up. Beeman needs a moment as he continues to sit on the floor. Teammates helping him up, and he looks like he'll be all right as he goes to shoot two free throws.
Zaire with his second foul. Trying to take Bolden out. Bolden, 20 points in the first half, just two here in the second, and Zaire's had a good job sticking with him.
This game could end up being decided at the free throw. Oh, and I stand corrected that it was not ruled a shooting foul. Everyone was going to the line.
Okay.
Now they're going to say that he did not have full possession of it. So the foul is still on Cedarburg, but instead it's just inbounded by Nicolet, and now a pass goes through the hands.
They're saying it was touched.
I definitely thought that Bolden had a hand on it, but apparently they're going to say it was deflected off of Cedarburg. Bolden never touched it. So I guess the officials are right on it, have a better vantage point than I do. You may have a better vantage point watching with us on the ESPN Madison YouTube channel. Just tap the left side of the screen, go back 10 seconds. You can go check the replay for yourselves.
Just watch the individual battles there and Bolden right now.
Left side.
Now we've got an offensive foul.
Yep, off the screen. An offensive whistle against Nicolet. They cannot catch a break. 8:19 to go in the game. 63-57. Cedarburg on top, trying to upset the fourth-ranked team in the state.
Shimon Davis having a good second half. Got 4 points here. Picked up his fourth foul.
O'Neal passes to Dykstra, left side. Free throw line extended left, picks up the dribble. Now off the screen, left side Zaire. Picks up his dribble a couple of steps in front of the free throw line. Pass right side. Now tap back O'Neal and a whistle. O'Neal traveled. Nicolet basketball, 7:59 to go. Trailing by six. Jesse Nelson, Dennis Semrau, Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania. Special shout out to Hunter Vaughn, our video producer, making the trip down to Cedarburg with us tonight. Alex Gravatt, our audio producer, back in the Everlight Solar ESPN Madison studio. Assisted by Chuck Stanger. Left side. Bolden, step back, no good, off the front of the rim. Rebound, Cedarburg. Logan Zaire, cross court, left side. Oh, driving baseline, yes. And a chance to go to the line for three. Ryan O'Neill draws the contact, gets it to fall. Cedarburg back up eight with a chance to make it more. 7:31 to go in the game. This is a fun basketball game, Dennis. You had a good one the other night with Alex Strofe over at Verona Area High School, Sun Prairie West in Verona. This one maybe even better.
Yeah, we saw Chris Davis Jr. put up 41. Trey Poteet put up 23, I think, and Murphy up 22. It was a good night.
O'Neill missed the free throw, got it back, attempted the three, no good. Second chance, Kaminsky, no. Nicolet got away with it. 8-point lead for Cedarburg. Kick it right corner, open three. Jordan Lovelace. No, he's not the quarterback. He's shooting threes. 65-60. Nicolet down just five. Approaching 7 minutes to play in the game. Bulldogs break through the pressure, right side of the floor. Logan Zaire driving inside. Whoa. Lowers the shoulder, had it stripped away, falls to the floor, no whistle. Nicolet ball. Pull up three, Lovelace, good again. Timeout, 6:48 to go. 65-63, Cedarburg hanging on to a 2-point lead after back-to-back threes by Jordan Lovelace, the senior guard, in off the bench. First time calling his name tonight. Dennis, he had a heck of a 30-second run right there.
Yeah, 8 threes on the season in 16 games. He just got back-to-backers. Double digits now, coming in with 3 points a game, and double that with six. Yeah, it's like, who is that guy? Call timeout. Now, Cedarburg just down to one timeout.
Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania, brought to you by the GRB Academy. Baseball for the serious player. The GRB Academy wants to be part of your plan to reach your potential. Utilize GRB Academy's 52,000-square-foot facility, 14 batting cages, and 6,000-square-foot weight room. Personal lessons available year-round. With over 300 college players and over 150 Division I players, the GRB Academy led the way in the Midwest for college recruitment and player development and continues to do so. Visit grbacademy.com for more information. The GRB Academy, baseball for the serious player. Jesse Nelson, Dennis Semrau, Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania at Cedarburg High School. Fourth-ranked Nicolet trailing by two with 6:48 to go. It goes without saying there is a long way to go in this basketball game.
Well, last time Nicolet had a lead was 12-11. There's been a couple of ties early, but this has been pretty much Cedarburg's game. Got it up to 13, got up to 14, but Nicolet just keeps clawing back.
Breaking through the pressure, left side of the floor. Pump fake gets the defender in the air. That was a great move by Dykstra. Easy layup, good for two with the left hand off the glass. 67-63, Cedarburg by four out of the timeout.
Now that's why you call a timeout. Execute a play right off of it. It was a good look and a nice jump stop there to get on ball off the glass.
Bolden to Beeman. Beeman left hand off the glass, good. He has 12 points in the second half, 18 in the game. 67-65. Cedarburg by two, approaching 6 minutes to play. Bulldogs nearly threw it away. It ends up in the hands of Brown.
Whoa.
Now the defense pursuing, and it's knocked out of bounds by Rashad Davis, who stares down the Bulldog bench he's right in front of.
That was 11-on-11 there. It looked like he was going to get an open pass. That's when he's got to take one more step to the ball. If he does, that might end up being a foul, the way Davis just flashed across the court. But he got a hand on it, and the possession still stays at Cedarburg.
A little edgy here at Cedarburg High School here in the second half as this game intensifies. 5:50 to go, 67-65. Right side of the floor, driving, French kicks it up. three. Dykstra, no good. Tap back into the hands of Dykstra. Into the paint. And a whistle as the shot goes up and good. But they're going to say it's on Cedarburg. Was that a travel? I couldn't see it from my vantage point. I don't think they called a foul on anybody. So, yes, we'll assume that was a travel on Dykstra. 67-65. Nicolet with a chance to take the lead if they could hit a three-point shot here. And the Cedarburg and Nicolet fans both getting a little noisy. We might have to come to the North Shore more often. Spinning his way downhill. Oh, it's no good for Beeman. Loose ball. Nicolet has it. Right side and a foul. Davis.
Good hustle on the offensive boards by Rashard Davis. And drew the foul.
It is not a shooting foul. They're saying that he was looking
still,
to pass the ball.
Still, that's not number six foul.
Yeah, that was the last one to give for Cedarburg, and it's the fourth foul now on Owen Hallbeck, the junior. Nicolet inbounding beneath its own basket on the right side. It comes in cleanly. Davis in the right corner. Fakes using the screen, drives baseline, and a block is called on Dykstra. That's his fourth. 5:12 to go in the game, and a 1-1 shooting opportunity at the line for the Nicolet Knights. They could tie the game if they can hit both.
Great first step there, and Dykstra tried to slide the body over to deny the baseline, but nope, Davis just way too quick for him. He got the spot and draws the foul. Now he gets to go to the line.
47% free throw shooter. The sophomore Rashad Davis misses the front end. And a strong rebound by Logan Zaire. Approaching 5 minutes to go on PrepMania. 67-65, Cedarburg up by two. Trying to upset the fourth-ranked team in the state, playing without their best player, Davion Hannah. Left side, Owen Hallbeck. Down to the block, kick it up top. Open three off the mark, no good for Zach Brown. Rebound Nicolet, chance to tie or take the lead. Right side, Beeman going downhill off the glass. Contested shot, no good. Rebound Cedarburg, 4:40 to go in the game. Left side of the floor, they kick it in gear. Open three, yeah. How about a second chance? Yes, sir, Zach Brown. Play me that music.
Third three of the game, second of the second half. Great pass from Zaire to find the open look.
70-65, that was a much needed three. And now a whistle goes against Nicolet. 3 second violation, you don't see that every day.
Oh, my God, they actually called one of those? That's old school.
When I say you don't see it every day, you haven't seen it since the Dean was about 25 years old.
That's very old school. Cedarburg will take it, but now another turnover.
Here come the Knights. Oh, no! Bolden forgot to get the ball. He wanted to go up for showtime, and he lost it out of bounds. A dreadful mistake for Nicolet with 4:10 to play. 70-65. Cedarburg basketball with a 5-point lead. 4 minutes to go on PrepMania. Left side of the floor. Owen Hallbeck. Loose ball, scrum.
Another
stripped
turnover.
Away by Nicolet. What a job! And a quick bucket. Jordan Lovelace, 8 points. 70-67. Cedarburg by three. Bulldog basketball, 3:40 to go. Off the screen, right side. Beyond the arc. Bounce pass inside from Brown. Down to Zaire. Now it's kicked back out. Spinning his way. French lost control. Now goes to Zaire.
Yes.
Right baseline is good. What a move. Logan Zaire with the right hand. That's the magic number. 72-67. Cedarburg by five with 3:20 to go.
One-hand floater on the assist from French. Loveless. Not good this time.
Heat check three was no good. Cedarburg trying to push it out front. Dykstra rejected from behind. But the foul is called on Bolden. Three on three. That's the number three jerseys. And Bolden helps his counterpart Dykstra up after the hard hit from behind. I thought that was almost a clean block from Bolden. He read it perfectly. But the positioning for Dykstra drew the contact. And now he'll shoot two free throws with 3:10 to go.
And there's some sportsmanship. Love to see that at the high school level. These guys are playing hard, but it's still a game.
A good old-fashioned rivalry in the North Shore Conference.
Yep.
Cedarburg and Nicolet. Front end of the first of two free throws, no good for Dykstra. He's a 68% free throw shooter. What a game you're joining us for here on the ESPN Madison YouTube channel. And for those of you listening along on 100.5 ESPN, Jesse Nelson, Dennis Semrau. Second free throw, good.
9 of 15 at the line for Cedarburg. They're gonna, if they lose this one, they're going to kick themselves. 20 turnovers right now and some missed free throws.
73-67, Cedarburg up by six. Nicolet with the basketball, right side. Pump fake from beyond the arc, right wing. Davis now steps up to take the shot. Oh, and he drains it. Rashad Davis has been wanting it all night. He connects to make it a three-point game with 2:45 to go. Here come the Bulldogs. Off the screen, French, top of the key. Feeds it, trailing inside. Brown turnover. Threw it away. Here comes Nicolet in the hands of Bolden across the timeline. 2:30 to go. Bolden weaves his way through two defenders and lays it up off the glass. Good. He's got 24. 73-72. Cedarburg by one with the basketball. Double bonus the rest of the way for the Bulldogs. Nicolet would shoot one and ones if they go to the line. French, top of the key, retreats. Now dishes for Dykstra, approaching 2 minutes to go.
Nothing but a jumper. No forced shots out here now.
Brown.
Try to get to the free throw line or at least get two.
Griffin French had it tapped behind, from behind. It was nearly a takeaway.
Ooh,
for Nicolet.
That was close.
The Knights fans are furious. That would have been a lead for Nicolet because Bolden was all alone in front of the pack. Instead, two free throws for Cedarburg and the fourth foul on Dave Bolden. That is a huge call with a minute 50 to go. Griffin French to the free throw line. He's a 66% shooter on the year.
Some angry fans here.
Nicolet has not gotten a whistle all night.
Oh,
French misses the first free throw. He'll shoot a second. Timeout situation, just one remaining for Cedarburg. Three timeouts remain for Nicolet. What a game. Nicolet 13-3, undefeated in conference play. Cedarburg 10-6, 7-6, all of their losses this year in conference play. And that one way off the mark for French on the second free throw attempt. Pressure mounting in Cedarburg. Trying to upset the fourth-ranked team, Dennis.
9-17 from the line. They were perfect 4-4 in the first half. Just make a couple of free throws, you got a two-possession game. But now anything's going to happen here.
The Knights have the basketball into the front court, approaching 100 seconds to go. Driving right side, Beeman kicks it up top, swing it left into the hands of Lovelace. Couple extra passes back to the hands of Bolden, left side. Minute 35 to go. Kick it back. Pump fake. Davis, step back. Three for the lead. No good. Offensive board. Yes. And it's collected by Beeman, who draws a foul. Beeman to the line with a minute 26 to go. He can tie it and then give Nicolet the lead if he can connect on both. Nasir Beeman, 6'4 senior. 64% at the free throw line this season. He has 12 points in the second half. Make it 13 to tie the game. Knotted at 73 with a minute 26 to play.
Are you ready for some extra basketball tonight?
I'm ready for a fantastic finish, Dennis Semrau, whatever that means. Beeman's second free throw is good. Timeout. With a minute 26 to go, we'll take a 30-second timeout with them. Nicolet up one on Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
Jesse Nelson, Dennis Semrau, Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania. From Cedarburg High School in the North Shore Conference, Nicolet 74, Cedarburg 73, the fourth ranked team in the state playing without its best player, Davion Hannah, trying to survive on the road and avoid its first loss in conference play.
Cedarburg one full timeout left, Nicolet one full and a 30 left here as we're down to under 70 seconds. And a layup.
Look at the feed from French to Ryan O'Neal. Bulldogs back in front by one. Minute five to go. Right side of the floor, Bolden picks up the dribble. Needs some help, gets it from Davis. Davis calmly dribbles with the left hand near the midcourt circle. Under 1 minute to play. Pass to the right side, Beeman. Beeman right side, goes in between two defenders. Blocked! Down low! Hallback got it! Bulldog basketball. Playing keep away, Griffin French picks up the dribble, needs some help, throws it dangerously near midcourt. Cedarburg preserves it, 40 seconds to go. Into the lane, layup good, Griffin French. 77-74, pull up three for Nicolet to tie it, no good. Rebound Cedarburg, French in front. Foul, Dykstra, shot no good. He'll shoot two free throws with 24.8 to go. It's been frantic all night.
Coach Nick Mueller pacing like a caged cat here right in front of us. Front, right to the bench, right literally 5 feet away from me here. Go up looking at the scoreboard, looking at the floor. He's going, we got this. We got a chance to win this.
But it's not over yet. Dykstra to the line. Jack Dykstra is a 68% free throw shooter. 24.8 to go with Cedarburg up three. He'll shoot two no matter what. Dykstra takes a few dribbles, sets, fires, and hits. 78-74, it's a two-possession game. Nicolet has two timeouts left. I was a bit surprised they didn't choose to use one in transition on their last drive down the floor. Dykstra again. This is an important one to make it a five-point game, and he hits both. Ice for Dykstra. 23 seconds. Right side, Bolden drives between two defenders. Bolden kick it out to the corner. Lovelace needs some help, needs to find someone up top. Nicolet's got to go. 15 seconds, down by five. Back up top, a long three. Forced, no good, batted back. 8 seconds, Nicolet still has it. Lovelace for three, heaves it up, no good. Rebound Knights, it's loose. 2 seconds to go. A shot, doesn't matter, it's over. They're storming the floor at Cedarburg High School. The Bulldogs have upset the fourth-ranked Nicolet Knights. Here comes the student section. Bark and bite tonight for the Bulldogs.
Woof, woof, woof. The Bulldogs prevail. Hanging on there by the skin of their teeth. Before I said feisty and flashy, boy, I'll tell you, both teams were feisty tonight, but the Bulldogs just a little bit more. Some great offensive work at the end, and they made the free throws. They counted a couple of layups. And then the last three looks, they had three good looks down there at the end.
Cedarburg 79, Nicolet 74. A road trip to the North Shore Conference we won't soon forget on Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania. 79-74 is the final score. We'll step aside, come back for the post-game wrap-up after this on Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania.
Working at a company that truly cares and invests in their employees should never be taken for granted. Work, learn, and earn at the Weld School at Stoughton Trailers. The program includes 1 week of paid training starting at $18 per hour and features small class sizes designed for individual attention. No prior experience is needed because teaching their employees is all part of the Stoughton Trailers way. Graduate into a full-time position in Stoughton or Evansville. Apply today at stojobs.com. That's stojobs.com.
Brian here from Canopy Wealth Management. At Canopy, we commit to full transparency in everything we do.
Because we're a fiduciary, we strive for the highest industry standards and honor our ethical duty to put your best interests first. Our balanced approach helps guide you through a complex and ever-changing landscape, creating a personalized wealth management experience. Care, competence, and clarity isn't just a tagline, it's a promise. Go to canopy-wealth.com to get started today. That's canopy-wealth.com.
Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania on ESPN Madison and the ESPN Madison YouTube channel. Cedarburg upsets fourth-ranked Nicolet with a final score of 79-74. Jesse Nelson, Dennis Semrau, it is our pleasure to be joined by Logan Zaire, tonight's player of the game. Logan, congratulations. What a win for your Cedarburg Bulldogs.
It was awesome. This is a huge win for us, and it's awesome to get it tonight.
Now, no Davion Hannah for Nicolet, but this is a revenge game for you guys after falling to them by double digits earlier in the season. What was it that made this game so important for you guys to pull away with the victory?
We just know that this is an amazing team that we had to play against, so we prepared this week, and our coach got us ready, and these fans also here, they brought great energy, and it made us play great.
First half, Dave Bender, 20 points. You had him in the second half. What was the message at halftime from Coach Mueller?
We just got to play hard, keep playing hard. We got to outwork them and just finish the game and win it.
You finished with 24. Is that more important or the four that he had in the second half?
Probably the four that he had in the second half, yeah.
And you want to talk about the bench players. You had a couple guys really came in the first half that just contributed, that maybe averaged about five or six total, and they were on fire tonight.
Yeah, our bench guys are awesome. They came in and played with a lot of energy. That's what we need to beat this good of a team. So it was awesome.
Logan, I'm seeing some marks on your arm here. You're scrappy out there.
Yeah.
Huge
the,
night.
The word feisty, describe your team?
Yeah. I think it's a great way to describe our team. We're like that in practice. You know, we fly around, dive on loose balls. It's just what our motto is. It's what we tried to be.
You play football at all?
Yeah.
What position?
Wide receiver and safety.
You can tell on defense, right? Yeah. You got that little physical presence out there, the football guys?
Yeah. It's awesome. Football makes it awesome. You get physical and amazing.
Logan Zaire, player of the game tonight from the Cedarburg Bulldogs, joining us here on the Prep Mania postgame. Logan, Dennis and I don't usually make it down here to the North Shore Conference. We're usually covering the teams in the greater Madison area. We came down here and we knew this would be a fun game to cover tonight. Is it like this every night in the North Shore? This is crazy.
I mean, not like every night, but this is a big game and everyone came out here to come support us. So it's just an awesome environment to play in.
Awesome. Congratulations.
Thank
Logan.
You.
Heck of a game. Thank Logan Zaire.
Thank you.
Player of the game, Cedarburg Bulldogs, as they get the win over fourth-ranked Nicolet. Dennis and I will be back to wrap it up with the Prep Mania postgame after this on Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania on ESPN Madison, the ESPN Madison YouTube channel.
Your Honda gets you everywhere. When it needs service, you need Zimbrick Honda Service. Their customer service is second to none, and you can experience it yourself at two convenient Madison locations on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Honda certified technicians handle it all. You can even get flexible payment options. Fix your car now and pay later. Apply online to see your options in seconds with no hard credit check. Make your service appointment online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Zimbrick Honda Service Center on Fish Hatchery Road and Grand Canyon Drive. Part of the Madison community since 1973. Shop Zimbrick Honda.
Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania on ESPN Madison and the ESPN Madison YouTube channel. Jesse Nelson and the Dean, Dennis Semrau. Our final score at Cedarburg High School, 79-74. Cedarburg defeats fourth-ranked Nicolet. Stoughton Health provides trusted care close to home. They are proud to support all of the area's student-athletes and wish them all the best this season. From rehab to ortho care, Stoughton Health provides comfort and convenience locally. Visit stoughtonhealth.com to learn more.
Yeah, Dave Bolden had 20 in the first half, and Coach Mueller just said, I said, what did you say at halftime? He said, walking off the floor, Logan Zare said, I want him in the second half. He says, don't worry, you already got him. Did a little bit of boxing one, a couple of specialty things, but wherever Bolden went, that's where Zare was. So Beeman had to pick it up in the second half. He ended up with 14 of his 20. Bolden still phenomenal game at 24. Without Hannah, you get him back in that mix. We could be seeing Nicolet. I wouldn't be surprised to see Nicolet in the Kohl Center, but when you get down to it, their sectional is going to be a conference tournament. These teams could meet for a third time. Oh, I'd love to be there for that one, I'll tell you.
Time for our final haul, brought to you by Stoughton Trailers. Since 1962, Stoughton Trailers has been a family-owned and operated business with competitive wages and excellent benefits, plus growth and advancement opportunities. Stoughton Trailers is an exciting place to grow your career. Join the collaboration, innovation, and dynamic team atmosphere at Stoughton Trailers, with positions now open in production, operations, finance, sales, engineering, supply chain, and more. Go to stojobs.com to apply today. On behalf of Stoughton Trailers, best of luck to all the teams competing this season. Stoughton Trailers, big opportunities. For the final haul, after Cedarburg's 79-74 win over the fourth-ranked Nicolet Knights, I turn it over to the Dean, Dennis Semrau.
This was a team effort for the Bulldogs tonight. As you mentioned, Zare finished with tied game-high honors with Bolden, each had 24. But then three more in double figures, 18 for Jack Dykstra, hit two big free throws there at the end, 11 each for Ryan O'Neill and for Zach Brown. I had six for Kaminsky, Joe Kaminsky, two for Reed Montague, one for Owen Hallbeck, and a deuce in there for Mitchell Tchaikovsky. But I'll tell you, the two guys really impressed in the first half. Kaminsky and O'Neill came off the bench to combine for 11. O'Neill had six more there in the second half. They really gave him a big spark. You can't do it with one guy, but I'll tell you, Logan Zare was a second-team all-conference guy last year. He's a first-teamer in my book. On both ends of the court, he did a great job defensively. Other side was 24 for Bolden. Beeman had 20, and Rashard Davis with 11. He really came up big time there in the second half. But they missed Hannah tonight, but still, you got to go with what you got, and there's a lot of talent on both sides of the floor.
Prep Mania brought to you in part by Pasquale's Cantina. Before or after the game, Pasquale's Cantina is the perfect spot for authentic Southwest flavors right here in the Madison area. Whether it's to fulfill your craving for red chile, their famous chips and fresh guacamole, or those blue corn tortilla tacos, Pasquale's is the place to enjoy time with friends and family. Visit one of their locations in Middleton or Verona today, or check out the menu and their food online at pasquallescantina.com. Bringing the flavors of the Southwest to the Midwest, Pasquale's Cantina. I don't think they'll be open, Dennis, when we get back to Madison from Cedarburg tonight. About a 90-minute drive, so we'll have to check them out for lunch maybe tomorrow to celebrate an amazing trip down here to the North Shore
Conference.
What
a road trip, yeah.
Cedarburg at home with the 79-74 upset win over the fourth-ranked Nicolet Knights. Dennis, our final takeaways from this game, for me personally, this looks like two teams that could compete deep into the postseason. Nicolet, of course, without their best player, Davion Hannah, tonight, a four-star recruit for the class of 2025, 33rd ranked nationally. When he's healthy, coming back from the flu, getting back on the floor, as this team gets into March, I'm sure they will be one of the forces to be reckoned with in Division II.
Yeah, well, God, we didn't even mention the first half. Loveless for Nicolet came at two dagger threes and then another two. Guys, just, again, a game like this, you want to see who rises to the occasion. And these teams, again, they could meet for that third time, and I would not be surprised to see them go double overtime or something happen to try to get the state.
Cedarburg's an interesting case. They improved to 11-6 on the year. They're 8-6 in conference play. You think, well, what happened to this? How do they lose six games? North Shore is as good as any conference in the state in basketball right now. Ranked teams everywhere. Recruits everywhere that are going to play at the Division I level. What's to say Cedarburg can't go on a run in March?
Well, there's a lot of great players around the state, but when you see our six Mr. Basketball finalists are all from the Milwaukee area, that's how much talent is in there in the suburbs. Just tremendous. And we saw an awesome game tonight. Thanks to the athletic director, Mr. Hannum, for hosting us tonight, and for Coach Mueller. And then I have to shout out to Terrence. Terrence left. I come here and say, what kind of candy do you like? And I went, oh, okay. He gave me a couple of bags of candy when I showed up. I don't know if it was bribery. I have nothing to do with the officials, but both coaches were phenomenal this week, too, and they got two really good teams. I was glad we made the trip.
A note to the future coaches when we're on Prep Mania. Give the Dean candy. It'll go a long way. Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania. For nearly 50 years, Zimbrick Honda's provided the Madison area with quality Honda vehicles, and the trusted staff of Zimbrick Honda's used car dealership will save you time and reduce your car buying stress by finding the vehicle that matches your style. If you're in the market for a new or used Honda, visit Zimbrick Honda in Madison today or online at ZimbrickHonda.com. Once again, our final score, Cedarburg, 79. Fourth-ranked Nicolet, 74. The Knights pick up their first loss of conference play in the 2023-24 season. Cedarburg improves to 8-6 in conference play, 11-6 overall on the year. Special thanks once again to our audio producers, Alex Gravatt and Chuck Stanger, back in the Everlight Solar Studio. To our video producer, Hunter Vaughn, making the 90-minute trip to Cedarburg with us. And, of course, for the Dean, Dennis Semrau. My name's Jesse Nelson. What a game in the North Shore. 79-74, Cedarburg beats Nicolet. Thanks for joining us. This has been Zimbrick Honda's presentation of Prep Mania on 100.5 ESPN and the ESPN Madison YouTube channel.